So hello everyone and welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's session, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 8th to 14th of September 2022. That is the second week of September 2022. All right. And I hope guys your preparations for NABARD Grade A Phase 2 are going on and result bahut jaldi aane wala hoga. I believe is hafte mein result aa jana chahiye. Right. So all the very best for the results and for the upcoming Phase 2 examination. All right. Let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, if you want to have the PDF of this session, then you can join the Telegram channel. The link for that is provided in the description. Okay. You will get the PDF with marked answers. Right. So let's talk about the very first question, which is about the PLI scheme for electronics manufacturing. Right. This is important. Now consider the following statements with respect to PLI scheme for electronics manufacturing and you have to identify the correct statement. Now you must be wondering, this scheme was launched in the year 2020, then why we are discussing it today? So we are discussing it today because it is in news, because the Ministry of Electronics and IT headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav has approved the very first disbursement under PLI scheme for electronics manufacturing, and that is why it is in news. And it is our duty to study this about this scheme. Okay, now talking about the scheme, so remember the objective, it is very clear to give a boost to the electronics manufacturing sector in the country by incentivizing the manufacturers. Right, it was launched in the year 2020 till 2025-26. Initially it was launched for a period up to financial year 25, but later on it was extended by one financial year, that is up to financial year 2026. Okay. Now under the scheme, remember, an incentive of 4% to 6%, right? 4% to 6% on net incremental sale of manufactured good is provided to the manufacturer, thereby incentivizing them and to give a boost to them to promote or increase the electronics manufacturing in the country. Okay. Talking more about this, total outlay of the scheme is 38465 crores. It is important, and the companies to which the incentives will be provided by the ministry were selected in two phases, and in each phase 16 companies were selected. Okay, which means total number of companies which will get incentive under this scheme is how many? 32. Right. And finally, there is an empowered committee under the scheme which has approved the first disbursement worth 53.28 crores under the scheme. Kisko disbursement hui hai, that is not important for your examination. Right. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. It was launched in 2020 till 24-25. Yes, it was launched in 2020, but not till 2024-25. It is being implemented till financial year 2026. Total outlay of the scheme is 48465 crore. It is not 48465. It is 38465. Once again, yeah, 38465. And under the scheme, an incentive of 2% to 6%. Is that so? No. The incentive is ranging from 4% to 6%. So none is correct will be the correct answer, option D. All right. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. In which of the following, with which of the following industry bodies, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, headed by Narendra Singh Tomar, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Morena, right, in Madhya Pradesh, has launched project management unit on public-private partnership in agriculture to collaborate with private players to strengthen the agriculture sector. The basic aim, the basic objective of establishing this project management unit is to enhance the farmer's income, right, is to enhance the farmer's income. Farmer ki income ko badhane ke liye ye project management unit banaya gaya hai, and in this project management unit, what will happen, the private players will be invited, private players ko invite kiya jayega, so that they unki infrastructure ki unke unka jo idea hai uska madad liya jayega to enhance the farmers income. All right, so let's talk about it. Remember, it has been launched in collaboration with FICCI, right? FICCI chair, FICCI's president is who? Mr. Sanjeev Mehta. Sanjeev Mehta is the president of FICCI, and as I told you, it has been launched to collaborate with private players to strengthen the agriculture sector, and the primary objective is to enhance the farmers' income by creating additional value ranging from provisioning of quality inputs, technology extension to market linkages, and value addition. Right, so these are some of the interventions which will be provided by the private players to enhance the income of farmers. Alright. So that is all, and therefore the correct answer is what? Option B. Option B, FICCI, is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 3 then. How much amount is provided as cash assistance to the patients suffering from TB for their nutritional support? Now this is, guys, something important, and this can be asked in your exam. This support, this financial incentive, this financial support is provided to the TB patients under a scheme which is known as Nikshay Poshan Yojana. Nikshay Poshan Yojana, and this is of course being implemented under National TB Elimination Program. There is a National TB Elimination Program under which the target is to eliminate TB is by the year 2025, as we all know this, right? So uske under Nikshay Poshan Yojana ke under jo TB patients hain unko 500 rupees diye jate hain for their nutritional support. But the question is, why we are discussing it? Because very recently President of India has launched Pradhan Mantri TB Mukt Bharat Abhiyan. Pradhan Mantri TB Mukt Bharat Abhiyan to eliminate TB by the year 2025. Now let me tell you one thing, that in 2018 this summit was held, Delhi End TB Summit. And in this summit, which was held in the year 2018, the target of eliminating TB by the year 2025 was set, and it was set by the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, right? So now this PM TB Mukt Bharat Abhiyan has been launched, and isme kuch aisa naya karne wale nahi hai, theek hai? All the things which are already undergoing under National TB Elimination Program, those things will continue. Basically ek naya naam diya hai isko, aur ek isme kya hoga, kuch naye campaigns chalaye jayenge, new campaigns will run, and awareness generation program honge to eliminate TB by the year 2025. Now the nodal ministry of course will be the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Mansukh Mandavia. And during this launch event, Nikshay Mitra initiative was also launched. Nikshay Mitra initiative was launched to provide additional support in the area of diagnostic, nutritional and vocational to the TB patients, right? And Nikshay 2.0, Nikshay, the second edition portal has been launched, where additional patient support to improve the treatment outcome of TB patients will be provided, right? So basically what you have to remember is that President of India has launched Prime Minister TB Mukt Bharat Abhiyan, Nikshay Mitra initiative has been launched to provide additional support to the patients, and then there is a portal which has been launched, which is named as Nikshay 2.0, and rupees 500 is provided as nutritional support. It is provided as nutritional support under a yojana which is known as Nikshay Poshan Yojana. Which is known as what? Nikshay Poshan Yojana. Right? Do remember the name of that yojana as well. And therefore, the correct answer is what? Option C, rupees 500. Alright? Moving ahead to question number 4. Name the initiative launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri, and he is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, to focus on mobilizing citizen action and commitment towards the vision of building garbage-free cities. Now, to make the cities garbage-free, this initiative has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and there are various initiatives which have been launched, which will definitely be launched in future to make India a clean place, right? So this initiative this time is known as what? Swachh Amrit Mahotsav. This is known as what? Swachh Amrit Mahotsav, and it has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Don't get confused with the Ministry of Jal Shakti, right? And it is a fortnight event which will focus on mobilizing citizens and their commitment towards achieving the target of making all the cities garbage free, right? Garbage free banana is the target. And during this event, there is this India Swachhta League was launched. What is this India Swachhta League? It is nothing but an intercity competition in which the participants will showcase their their unique initiative which they have launched for sanitation purposes, right? So that is all. You just have to tell the name. This is Swachh Amrit Mahotsav. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 5 pe aa jaate hain. Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana, very very important question, has completed 2 years of successful implementation now. As per the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, headed by Purushottam Rupala, What is the growth rate of fishery sector from 2019-20 to 21-22? So on completion of two successful years of Pradhan Mantri Sampada Matsya Sampada Yojana, the ministry has released some data regarding the achievements of Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. So let's talk about those data. Number one, the ministry has said that the fishery sector has shown a growth of 14.3% in the last 2 years, that is from financial year 20 to financial year 22. Then the ministry is saying that the fish production has reached an all-time high in the previous financial year, that is financial year 22. And how much? 161.87 lakh tons, right? And finally, the third thing, exports, an all-time high exports of 13.64 lakh tons was done, which was worth ₹57,587 crores in the financial year 2022. So these are the most three most important achievements which have been achieved after the implementation of Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana, right? And our question is also based on this, and the correct answer is what? Once again, yeah, option D, 14.3% is the correct answer, because that is the growth rate which has been shown by the fishery sector from 2019-20 to 2021-22. Moving ahead to question number 6. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi has inaugurated the International Dairy Federation World Dairy Summit 2022 at India Expo Center and Mart in Greater Noida. Before 2022, it was held in India in which year? 2022 se pehle India mein kab hua tha? That is the question, right? So in this summit, guys, there is nothing which is required for the examination, right? Bahut zyada detail mein isme jaane ki zarurat nahi hai, bas it is a summit. Bahut sari discussions hongi, badi badi baatein hongi, aur uska koi matlab nahi hai exam mein, right? So remember, aapko do teen cheeze hai, but yes, aapko yaad rakhni hai, it was inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, right? And it is the event of International Dairy Federation, which is headquartered in Brussels, which is of course in Belgium, right? And where it took place at India Expo Center and Mart, which is in Greater Noida. And Greater Noida is in the Gautam Buddha Nagar district of Uttar Pradesh, right? It is in UP. Now the theme of the summit was Dairy for Nutrition and Livelihood. And in India, the last time this World Dairy Summit took place in the year 1974. Okay, 1974, and these are the two important milk statistics of India. India produced 146 million tons in the year 2014, but today this number has been increased to 210 million tons, which is of course a big achievement. And India's milk production growth rate is 6%. Alright, so that is all. Itna kafi hai, isse zyada aapko detail mein jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. And the last time this summit took place in India in the year 1974, option E is the correct answer. And you should remember the headquarters of International Dairy Federation as well. It can also be asked. Moving ahead to question number 7. What is the export target of agricultural and processed food products for the year 2022-23? Very, very important question again for the upcoming NABARD grade examination, phase 2. So, what is the export target of agricultural and processed food products in this financial year, the current financial year? Okay, let's talk about it. So, remember, there is a data that is released by Directorate General of Commercial Intelligence and Statistics regarding the exports in the agricultural and processed food products in for this period of April to July 2022. Now, why we are discussing for this period? Because we have the phase 2 of NABARD examination next month. Okay, na? So that is why they can ask you this. Generally, kya hota hai ki annual mein se ya yearly wale mein se question aata hai, but abhi kyunki bahut hot topic hai ye aur agle hi mahine NABARD ka exam hai, तो इसमें से इसलिए क्वेश्चन पूछा जा सकता है, राइट? सो फॉर द पीरियड ऑफ अप्रैल टू जुलाई 2022, द डेटा रिगार्डिंग एग्रीकल्चर एंड प्रोसेस्ड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स हैव बीन रिलीज्ड बाय डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ कमर्शियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स, एंड दिस डेटा हैव शोन दैट देयर इज एन इंक्रीज अप देयर इज एन इंक्रीज बाय 30%. द एक्सपोर्ट्स इन एग्रीकल्चर एंड प्रोसेस्ड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स हैव बीन इंक्रीज बाय 30% in April to July 2022 as compared to the same period in the year 2021. Alright, and total amount agar pucha jaye to that is US$9598 million, right? For the year 2022-23, The export target in the area of agriculture and processed food products, it is how much? US dollar 23.56 billion dollars का target है exports का in agriculture and processed food products in this financial year. This is very important. अगर इसमें से कुछ पूछा जाएगा तो I think वो यही होगा. Now these are the performance of various crops which has shown various growth rate. Like crop में सबसे पहले अगर हम बात करें fresh fruits and vegetables, so it has shown a 4% growth as in the period of April to July 2022 we are talking, and we are comparing it with the period of April to July 2021. All right, processed fruits and vegetable have shown a whooping growth of 51%. Cereals 37.75%, basmati rice 29.13%, and finally meat, dairy and poultry products it is 11.69%. Right, agar ye yaad ho jata hai to well and good, agar nahi hota hai to bhi I don't think there is an issue, because I don't think ki exam mein aana chahiye. But yes, these days they are asking anything, so ab jab anything pooch rahe hai to fir anything mein to kuch bhi ho sakta hai, right? So therefore the correct answer is what? The correct answer is $23.56 billion, because that is the target, export target of agriculture and processed food products in financial year 2023. Question number 8. Niti Aayog in collaboration with Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has released national health account estimates for 2018-19, and I should not tell you how much important this national health account data is. As per the estimates, what is the per capita government spending on healthcare in 2018-19? So there are a lot of data with from lot of variables. So let's talk about them. So remember, it has been released by Niti Aayog in collaboration with Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, but the report has been prepared by National Health System Resource Center. All right. National Health System Resource Center, which is designated as National Health Accounts Technical Secretariat. National Health Account Technical Secretariat का दर्जा किसको मिला हुआ है? National Health System Resource Center को. And this National Health Account estimates are prepared by using an accounting framework, which this framework was prepared by WHO, and it is known as System of Health Accounts 2011. Right? Let me repeat this. The National Health Account estimates have been prepared by using an accounting framework, and this accounting framework is based on international standard of System of Health Accounts 2011, which was developed by World Health Organization. All right, and now let's talk about the data. Government health expenditure as a percentage of GDP, it was 1.15% in 2013-14, and it increased to 1.28% in 2018-19. Now comparison भी show कर रखा है, तो comparison वाले में अगर आपको increase वाला याद रखना है तो वो रख सकते हो. Like for example, here it is an increase of 74%. This you can remember. बाकी you have to remember this one. 2018-19 में क्या percentage है? Share of government health expenditure in total health expenditure, that is 40.6%. Government's health expenditure as a percentage of current health expenditure, that is 34.5%. Per capita government spending on healthcare is rupees 1815. This is very, very important. 1815, and there is an increase of 74% with respect to the financial year 2014. It was 1042 in that year. Primary healthcare expenditure 55.2%. Then there is share of primary and secondary care in government sector, it is 86%. Share of primary and secondary care, it is 70%. The out of pocket expenditure as percentage of total health expenditure, it is 48.2. Per capita out of expenditure, it is 2155, which has shown a decrease of 8%, right? But that is not all. There are three more data. Primary and secondary care accounts for more than 80% of the current government health expenditure. Government financed health insurance expenditure has now been increased by 167%. Of course, this is due to Ayushman Bharat. And foreign aid for health has come down to 0.4%, just 0.4% in 2018-19 from 2.3% in 2004-05. All right. So that is all. And now let's come back to the question. So what is the per capita government spending on healthcare? That's rupees 1815, which has been increased by a 74% as compared to the year 2013-14. Moving ahead to question number 9, and there are 22 questions today, right? The special campaign 2.0 has been launched to focus on Swachhata and reducing pendency in government departments. Which department or organization is the nodal agency to implement the campaign, right? So that is the question, and this is the second edition of special campaign launched by Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pension, right? This ministry ne launch kiya hai, and this ministry is headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh. Okay, so let's talk about this special campaign 2.0. What is this? Remember, this campaign has been announced to focus on Swachhata and reducing pendency in government departments, right? Last year it was also launched, and this campaign will run from 2nd of October to 31st of October. 2nd October to 31st October tak ye campaign chalega, and the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances is the implementing agency for this campaign, right? And a portal which is known as Swachhata portal has been launched by Dr. Jitendra Singh for effective implementation of this special campaign 2.0, right? So therefore, the correct answer is DARPG, that is Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. Now let's talk about the question number 10. Ministry of Jal Shakti, Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, has launched a white paper on urban wastewater scenario in India at International Water Association World Water Congress and Exhibition 2022. The question is where this exhibition took place. The question is very basic. Now remember, this white paper has been launched by Minister of Jal Shakti Gajendra Singh Shekhawat along with his Denmark counterpart, which means jo bhi wahan ki Ministry of Water Resources hogi, unka jo bhi minister hoga, unke saath ye launch kiya gaya hai. And this white paper, it reflects the current status of wastewater treatment in India and what are the potential pathways for future treatment infrastructure for wastewater treatment. All right. And it has been prepared by Atal Innovation Mission, National Mission for Clean Ganga, Ministry of Jal Shakti, International Agency Innovation Center of Denmark, and IIT Bombay. And it has been launched under Green Strategy Partnership between the two countries, India and Denmark. All right. And this exhibition took place in Copenhagen. Option A is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 11. Now from now onwards, the questions will be short questions which require no explanations, right? No detailed explanation. Zarurat hi nahi hai, kyunki itne mein hi sara uska detail aa jata hai question mein hi. Okay, but don't take these questions lightly. Inko aapko underestimate karne ki zarurat nahi hai, because RBI ke exam mein this year and NABARD ke phase 1 mein bhi dekha gaya that so many questions were asked from these news in short. Which company has collaborated with Ministry of Electronics and IT Startup Hub to launch a accelerator program to support and accelerate extended reality technology startups across the country? Now the startups which are working in the area of extended reality, they will be provided with the support by MeeT Startup Hub. What support they will be provided? So total 40 startups will be selected. Total 40 startups will be selected, and each startup will be provided with rupees 20 lakh as a grant. And this has been launched in collaboration with Meta. Option D is the correct answer. Where has the Ministry of Panchayati Raj, headed by Giriraj Singh, organized the conference on Smart Village Panchayat, empowering rural communities, leaving no one behind? So where this this conference has been organized? So it has been organized in Lucknow, the capital of Uttar Pradesh. Option B is the correct answer. I hope there is no problem in this. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has released the national list of essential medicines 2022. How many medicines are there in the list? So this is the fifth such list, right? Ye panchvi list hai. The very first list was released in the year 1996, then in the year 2003, then 2011, then 2015, and then the fifth one is this in the year 2022. And total there are 384 medicines which are listed in this medicine list. 76 startups have been onboarded under the India Water Pitch Pilot Scale Startup Challenge by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. They will be provided financial assistance to work in the fields of water supply, used water management, water body rejuvenation and ground water management etc. So how much financial assistance will they get? कितना financial assistance उनको मिलेगा under this challenge? So very direct question, it is rupees 20 lakh. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 15, All India Institute of Ayurveda has been chosen as the nodal agency for Ayurveda Day 2022. What is the theme of Ayurveda Day 2022? So it is Har Din Har Ghar Ayurveda. And when is Ayurveda Day celebrated? It is celebrated on the occasion of Dhanteras, 2 days before Diwali. And this is because Dhanteras is the birthday of Dhanvantri. Dhanvantri is the god. And he is considered as the god of Ayurveda. And that is why this Dhanteras is celebrated as Ayurveda Day on, Dhanteras, 2 days before Diwali. And this year the theme is Har Din Har Ghar Ayurveda. Name the portal launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, developed with the help of National Remote Sensing Center, Hyderabad. The portal will provide satellite images of water bodies to various cities to plan their rejuvenation. So you just have to name this portal, and guys, I think ye question aapke exam mein aana chahiye. It is Urban Water Body Information System. There is a full form of OS. It is Urban Water Body Information System. Right, so that is the full form of OS. Right, option A is the correct answer. 17th aa jaate hain. What was the theme of the 10th edition of webinar Igniting Young Minds, Rejuvenating Rivers, organized by National Mission for Clean Ganga? So the theme was natural farming. I don't think there is any requirement of going into the details of this webinar. That is not at all required. 18th aa jaate hain. Name the digital platform launched by Ministry of Mines through which people can gather information about working of Ministry of Mines. So the Ministry of Mines has launched this to bring about the transparency in the working of ministry, and the name of this platform is the Mining Arena. Option B, the Mining Arena, is the correct answer. 19th aa jaate hain. Under which scheme the Ministry of Rural Development is conducting a countrywide campaign to expedite the process of mobilization of left out poor rural women across 34 states and UTs into women's self-help groups? So I think out of all the options, the most feasible answer could be Day NRLM, and that is the correct answer to this question. Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Rural Livelihood Mission. Where has the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, headed by Bhupendra Yadav, who is also the Minister of Labour and Employment, organized the National Conference on Sustainable Coastal Management? I think same, there is no requirement of details, and this National Conference on Sustainable Coastal Management was organized in Bhubaneswar. Option C is the correct answer. 21. How many primary agricultural credit societies are targeted to be developed in the next 5 years? So this announcement has been done by the Minister of Cooperation, Amit Shah, and total 3 lakh PACS have been targeted to be constructed in the next 5 years. Option B. And the last question for today, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has set a target of reducing road accident and deaths by how much percent by the year 2024. Very, very important question. The correct answer is 50%. Alright, so that is for session today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.